I'm training them boys right. I'm training them boys right. Ask any of my nephew. Ask any of them. Ask my son. Yeah. They were 12, 13. They got hit.
Boosie, my brother. Like a lot of people, I saw your Instagram live where you were talking about your son and your nephews and what you do with them to make sure they turn out straight. Let's check it out.
Hell yeah, I got my son up. You right. Yes, a grown woman. Grown, super grown. Super grown. Check this ass out. Checked all my nephews out. Super grown. Yeah, that's why they got iPhone 11s. They can watch as much porn as they want. Yeah, it's better than them watching cartoons with two men kissing.
Bruh, with all due respect, that video is completely, completely out of pocket. There is absolutely no way we can justify having a 12-year-old child have sex with a grown adult. There are rules, there are laws, and all of that. But just at the basic level, a 12-year-old and an adult is a case of sexual assault or a case of sexual abuse. It's not just fun and good times. The other thing, my brother, is that having a 12-year-old boy have sex with a grown woman isn't going to do what you think it's going to do. It's not going to make sure that anybody is straight. It's not going to stop somebody from being gay. It doesn't do any of that. There are gay people in the world. There are lesbians in the world. There are bisexual people in the world. And their desires, their feelings, what they want and who they want doesn't change by forcing them to have sex with other people. The other thing, brother, is that we actually do harm. We do damage to our children when we force them to do things before they're ready. Even if your child is straight, forcing them to have sex with an adult may give them an unhealthy sense of what sex is. It may give them trauma. It may give them bad memories. I know plenty of brothers that grew up the way I grew up, the way you grew up, who had sex with the girl around the corner that was grown, or with a teacher, or in some neighborhoods like the suburbs, the babysitter. I hear these stories all the time, and yeah, dudes brag about it, but a whole lot of them got pain underneath that. A whole lot of them weren't ready for what they experienced. A whole lot of them are hurt and harmed because of that history. So we gotta make sure we're not doing hurt and harm to our children and in the name of trying to make them something that we want them to be. I understand what you're thinking right now. You're probably thinking, well, my son liked it. My nephews liked it. Yeah, they might have. I can't speak for your nephews and I can't speak for your son. I don't know them. But what I do know is we live in a world where even if they didn't like it, even if they didn't feel ready, they couldn't say that because we put so much pressure on black boys. We put so much pressure on them to be grown. That's the first thing we do. Whether they're 4, 5, 6 years old, we treat them like grown men. Sometimes we try to make them the man of the house. Even law enforcement, they look at our children who are 10 and 11 and 12 years old like Tamir Rice and they think they're 20 and use that to justify killing them. They make our boys into men. They make our boys into men. And then black men are expected to always be hypersexual, always want to have sex all the time. And so now we're taking a little boy and putting that onto him. And he might not be ready for that. He should never have to be ready for that. But when we do that, again, brother, we are doing harm even if we intend to do good. Now, I've heard you say before and I've heard other people say, well, there's an assault on black men. There's an assault on black masculinity. We got to protect our boys from all this stuff that's happening in the world. There's no gay conspiracy. There's no movement by the world to turn black men gay. Yes, there are black men who are gay. Yes, there are black men who are queer identified. They are who they are, and we can't change that by making them have sex with somebody else. Imagine if it were your daughter. Imagine if somebody said, my 12-year-old daughter might be gay one day, and I'm going to stop it from happening by having her have sex with grown-ass men. Think about how that would sound. Think about how that would feel. Boys are no different. We gotta protect our boys with the same intensity that we protect our girls. And even though the world right now is stacked against black women, even though right now the world has a rape culture that promotes the abuse and violence against black women and black girls all across the board, we still gotta remember that black boys gotta be conditioned and prepared and trained to have healthy attitudes towards sex too. To understand that their manhood and their identity isn't tied to their ability to have sex. Having sex with a grown woman shouldn't be our coming of age ritual. There's other things we can do to talk about manhood. There's other things we can do to talk about masculinity, like love, like support, like being emotionally available, like being disciplined. There are things we can do But this ain't it, my brother. This ain't it. And I know you're not the only one out there. There's a whole lot of people agreeing with you. I'm a little mad that more people were mad about you wearing Kappa paraphernalia than they were about this. That's crazy to me. Now, you also might be saying, I don't know this dude, and he need to mind his own business. First of all, my brother, as an African person, I believe that we are each other's business. We one big community. But also, a couple months ago, you intervened in Dwayne Wade's parenting and expressed your opinion because you felt like something was happening that was harmful. I disagree with you. I fully support Dwayne Wade. But now, the tables are turning, and I'm saying, look, brother, you publicly declared a certain kind of parenting, and I'm saying this isn't helpful. This is, in fact, harmful to the community, harmful to our children, and it's not about you personally. It's about the message it sends to all of us. We got to support each other. We got to invest in young black men, and we got to teach them that their identity, their manhood, their health, their worth, their value isn't tied to who they have sex with or their ability to have sex or how much they have sex. It's tied to something deeper, something better. And we got to honor that. We got to support that. And we got to advance that. So my brother, with love and respect, I tell you, you got this one completely wrong. And hopefully we as a community can come together and build and think about a better way.